course, being where we came from, we call this one Desolation Sigma. In Cambridge, Massachusetts, on the River Charles Edge, on a strip of reclaimed marshland, in the shape of a sawed-off wedge, there stands an institution of great concrete and stone, a cold foreboding complex, and no place to call home. Government research lab, a diploma factory, scientific wonderland, this place called MIT. The newly entered freshman from high school, fresh and bright, loses his idealism that first fatal Wednesday night. In a room with 14 others, at home he's meant to feel, to contemplate his future and enjoy a commons meal. And the feelings of the students, how important what's one sixth place number in the scheme of MIT? On the day of registration, on your first day at the Tude, you stand in line 4 hours, your schedule to compute. That's a revered computer that gives you your program today, corrects its mistakes tomorrow in an equally rapid way. And the outlook of the outcome, it's as bleak as it can be. From 9 to 5, 6 days a week, you're trapped at MIT. Online to get your roll card at the end of a long, hard day. You're told to see the cashier, your overdue fees to pay. Then you get to meet the purser, a man of endless guile, with his hands in your back pockets, Betty Davis style. Then you realize the purpose of an MIT degree. You're building up the bankroll of the place called MIT. Go on with further courses, you find they're all the same. Started cutting classes, you too can play the game. 300 pages reading, a weekly problem set. It's the bane of your existence, but it hasn't killed you yet. And the thoughts and plans for graduation that fill your heart with glee, soon be through and many miles away from MIT. submit your thesis. The final hardest test, the committee of examiners, you're certain they're the best. King Kong and Cain and Abel, and the Hunchback of Notre Dame, or Killian Towns and Sarratton, to you it's all the same. Go to graduate school outside of MIT.
Thank you.